With Get Hirstified. I hope you're ready to get Hirstified tonight. Thank you so much for joining me. Looks like I'm going to be on every Tuesday at 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. So I hope you can join me and maybe, you know, help get through the week, you know, because these liberals will just drive you nuts. So anyway, we got a good show lined up for you, but I'm really happy that I've partnered up with New Right Network. And New Right Network has lots of different shows. So if you like mine, you'll love all the other ones. They have like a book of the month club. They've got gaming. They've got travel, health, mom stuff for parents. And we have Veterans Nation. That's really become a really big hit. And they help veterans around the country, you know, to transition and everything. So check it out. You can go to nrnplus.com and subscribe. You can do monthly subscriptions or shoot, do a whole year because you know what? You just love me that much. Why not? So, and then also they got awesome articles. If you go to newrightnetwork.com, you can check out a lot of their articles. I do share a lot of them on my Hirstified page. And yeah, so check it out. And they've partnered up with Vets for Trump, Ops Lens. I mean, we're all over the place. You're going to have getting Hirstified everywhere. So anyway, on the show, I'm going to talk about my Mega Monday post that I have on my Hirstified page every Monday. Man, we had some pretty funny comments. And there's a funny video. You're going to crack up. I've watched it probably 100 times. I was loving it. Absolutely loving it. So I got to share that with you. We're going to talk about, you know, the rhinos that we have at the Democratic Convention, the mail-in ballots. I mean, so it's on and on. Also, if you want a topic for me to talk about or my opinion on something, be sure to comment on here or just send me a, you know, a message or an email. I'm fine with that. So anyway, let's get on with the show. So we know it as rhinos. You know, you got Mitt Romney and all that. I tell you, they're really showing their colors. You think we've got diehard Republicans, and come to find out, they're not. Makes me ill, to be honest with you. You know, if you don't like our president, and you don't like what he does, leave the party, because we don't need you. We just don't need you. I don't need rhinos in the Republican Party. It's part of draining the swamp, okay? We're ready to go down. It needs to go down into the drain. These guys, they gotta go. They gotta go. At the flipping Democratic virtual convention, because obviously Biden can't leave his basement, okay? I mean, the poor guy, I really feel sorry for him. I really do. I mean, can the man eat solid foods? He might be in there eating applesauce because he's going senile. And I, you know, I'm not saying that to make fun of him, but the man needs to get checked. He needs to get checked. And for the Democrats to just subject this poor senile man is below the belt. Below the belt. You have to think about this. Anybody in their right mind, can they truly vote for Biden in good consciousness, knowing that Biden can run the country? The man's been in politics for 50 years. What has he done? What has he done? Nothing. The man's done nothing, okay? 50 years has accomplished nothing. He was vice president of the United States and did nothing for 8 years. What he did, this is what he did. He went around bribing people so his son Hunter, that has no experience whatsoever in anything, I'm surprised he can tie his shoes too, like his dad, and make millions. That's what Biden did, and that's what you guys want to vote in? I mean, this is crazy. I'm telling you right now, the man cannot get any legit votes. The only reason that anybody would vote for Biden is to vote against Trump. He's not getting votes because they want him. They're getting votes because they want Trump out. That's it. And how stupid can you be? Trump is actually accomplishing something. You're gonna vote somebody in that doesn't even know where they are? Really? That's why they keep him in the basement so he don't get lost. Keep him in a little 10 by 10 area. So he doesn't, really? And then people are like, oh, his gaffes. He stutters. Really? I have a friend that stutters. You stutter. You don't go, I'm in Wisconsin. No, Biden, you in Albuquerque. That's not stuttering. It's not stuttering talking about corn pop. It's not stuttering saying, oh, my sister, I mean, my wife, my daughter. I mean, really? And then you got Republicans endorsing this dude. They got Republicans endorsing him. I'm going to show you. Check this out. This is crazy. And you know what upsets me? I tell you how it upsets me. It upsets me because I actually liked this dude when he was running. John Kasich, Chachish, whatever your stupid last name is, because now I could care less and have a respect for you and pronouncing your name right. He's at the Democratic National Convention. I'm a lifelong Republican, but that attachment holds second place to my responsibility to my country. That's why I've chosen to appear at this convention. In normal times, something like this would probably never happen, but these are not normal times. No, you're not normal. You're not normal to go to the Democratic Convention and endorse Biden. If you are a Republican, there's no way I would have to, I don't know. I don't know what it would take for me to walk into a Democratic convention and endorse a man like Biden. I don't know. You're supposed to be a Republican. You ran on conservative values when you were running for president. Now all of a sudden, you're going to endorse somebody that pro-choice is okay. You can kill babies. You're going to endorse somebody that says, yeah, we need to take your guns away. You're going to endorse somebody that says we need to defund the police. You're going to endorse somebody that says it's okay to kneel during the national anthem. That really? And you're supposed to be a Republican? You ran for president? It makes me sick. You make me sick. You need to leave the party. You need to go. Go, 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 go. He wasn't the only one. There was four of them. You got him. You got the former New Jersey governor, Christine Todd Whitman. Remember this, people, election time. Remember this, election time. We need to get rid of Republicans like this. And former New York representative, Susan, I don't know, Malaria, I don't care. You know? And then you got Meg Whitman. She's a freaking billionaire. And she ran for California governor and lost after spending $178 million. $178 million on a campaign to run for governor? And you lost? Really? Maybe you might be a little upset that Trump didn't have to spend that much and won in a landslide. That's what John Kasich, whatever his stupid name is, That's what his problem is. He's still butthurt like Romney is, that he lost. Y'all are ridiculous. Makes me sick. You're just a sore loser. You lost. So what? So what? You're a big loser. So the only way, and I've said this 100 times, the only way Democrats could ever win is by cheating. It's what they do. They cheat. And I'm going to show you how they cheat. Now, they have this video. It's gone viral. I'm going to show you. And I found this, though, on this, in her area news. And we can close this out. So they were talking about that. Okay, so Tina Brown, she's going viral right now. She's in Palm Beach. So their news station covered this, okay? And let me just play the video. Here we go.
Round. But before sending them off, they noticed a key difference on their envelopes.
Look at my brother's, who's a Democrat. It says 4212D. That's Democrat. Then you go here, because we're both the same address anyway. 4212R. Oh my God, they can see who my political affiliation is.
Wow.
I don't like that.
She says she posted the video to educate other voters.
Please be wary. I just personally think we should not have our political affiliations on there.
The video has been viewed more than 120,000 times, even retweeted by President Trump.
What's the response been that you're getting?
Every single one of them has been positive for the exception of three. And we're talking about thousands.
We've had calls.
The supervisor of elections in Martin County, Vicki Davis, says the labeling makes sure voters get the proper primary ballot for their party affiliation. Florida is a closed primary state, and that she feels fraud as a result of this labeling would be highly unlikely.
Now, I don't know that a postal worker would have the time to go through ballots in their general workday and remove those ballots.
Really? You don't think they're going to have time? They're going to make time. They're going to make time, homie, and they're going to see the odds, and they're going to go, oh, toss, 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 toss. Trust me. And you know why? I'm going to show you why. Because bam-o, bam, the Postal Carrier Union endorses Biden. Really? And you flippin' think that they're not going to take the time to go through and be like, oh, at all. Done. Yeah, that's what they're going to do. Exactly. You probably feel the same way. It's very frustrating. Yeah. So if you're getting ticked off like me, let's take a little break breather here. Okay. I'm gonna do that. So I want to show you something that was really funny. Y'all, I was dying. Okay, you got to check this out. All right, here we go. I'm going to share this with you. A buddy of mine sent this to me, and then all of a sudden everybody started sending it to me. All right, here we go. Check this out. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. If you haven't seen it, you're going to die.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate.
Wait, if you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, then you ain't black.
We all nations should be self-evident. All men and women are created by the thing.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
Ha ha ha. goodness. Oh, that's hilarious. I don't know who did that. I'm going to have to find out who did that video. But that had me busting up. Had me busting up. That's funny. I just had to share that with y'all, y'all. I said, I'm going to post that video on my Hirstified. I'm going to put it on Twitter, Instagram, and on my page and that too. And I'll see if they want to share it on New Right Network. That had me rolling. That's so funny. The mega train, getting on them. That's funny. Okay. So if you don't know, I headed up with some friends of mine, Mike, Byron, and all that, and they helped me out with the route for the parade and everything else. So we had, it was called Trumptilla, Backs the Blue, Freedom Boat Parade. And we were there, and we just wanted to support our law enforcement, our military, our veterans, our first responders, all that, because they do so much for our country. And I don't really think that they get enough appreciation, and especially with everything that's going on, especially with the whole defunding the police. I really thought it was time that we show them that we appreciate them. And we have a president right now that appreciates them, not a presidential candidate that is looking to defund the police. So I thought, what better than to, have a Trump parade? So we called it Trumptilla, and it was a boat parade. And I want to share it with you. Although I got completely pummeled with the rain, okay, it started to rain, and I'm going to show you in some of the pictures. We had a mannequin, a Trump mannequin, and I'm standing there, and I'm like trying to hold him so he doesn't, fall over, get blown over, because I'm telling you, the freaking wind was like a typhoon. It was crazy. So I'm holding him, making sure, and I'm just, it's just pummeling in my face, it was crazy. So, and then we even put a poncho on him. It was fabulous, absolutely fabulous. It was so good. I want to say, I'm serious. I really think we had close to 400 boats, even with the rain, because when we passed the boat launch, they still had tons, like lined up for like blocks of people still trying to launch their boat. So, so super excited, and we're going to do it again. I know. I can't wait. So here we go. I just want to share a few of the pictures, now I'm going to make a video, and I'm going to try to send it to the president, because, he was all about boat parades and stuff. He even, said that little snippet. Here we go. Here's one, a sailboat. Oh, you can barely hear that. Look, somebody even had a cutout of them. Check it out. That is a huge shrimp boat, and they had somebody dressed up in it with the Trump mask on. This was our boat. See, this, we had the Trump mannequin right there, and so my buddy Mike helped out with everything, and then Byron, he's here with his brother Mike. They helped me out too. It was really awesome. Here's some pictures of all the boats. There's the sailboat again. Look at that, y'all. Now I'm telling you, we would have had more than that, probably two times as much as that. But with that rain, it really did kind of hurt. Look, this is a great picture. This is what we were going into. Yeah. How crazy is that? This was on the yard. We had the concert. We were kind of over here singing and everything. And these are our little boats up in the front. There's the sailboat again. Yeah, we got, oh, look at this. I love this photo. So, we just had, look. That's a huge, down these canals. It went for blocks and blocks and blocks. There we are again. Oh, this one's funny. Look at the thing there. That's a good one. The tugboat. Oh my gosh, y'all. A huge freaking tugboat came through. It was awesome. He was the hit of the parade. We couldn't believe it. We had a huge tugboat. And he has already promised to come for the second one. Y'all, this is hilarious. This guy right here, look, he's got the Biden flag and it's upside down. It's upside down. And he's in like a little P-row, man. And it was funny because he like would put water in it, in there, and he would like put a bail out, and he kept like putting the buckets out, like bailing out water, like he was sinking. And he had the white surrender flag. Oh my God, he was awesome. We have a video too later, and I'll put it in the big video about him needing to put on like a mega hat so he could survive. And so it was funny. It was good. He was a good sport. And there's the tugboat again. There's us again with the thing. Look, I'm telling you, y'all, that storm was a killer. We have one video, you know, like I said, I'm going to put it in the thing. Look at this. Look at this. Look how awesome. Look at these flags. Does this not like just make you feel so patriotic? Isn't this cool? Again, I think we would have had, this was at the concert. People starting to pull up at the concert. People were probably still, you know, trying to come in and everything. We would have had so much more than that if we didn't have that huge storm. Look, is that not, look at this lady. She's loving it. She's got her flag out there. It ain't stopping her. Rain don't stop us Trump supporters and patriots. I love it. This is what we went through, y'all. It was a bad storm. Let's see. Oh, so anyway, so we got video. This is a great pic. I like that. Very artistic. Here's more of, you know, with the concert. But we have a video. Oh, look, a little Trumpy bear. Video. Oh, there's the Biden guy again. Of more. Because I only got. Oh, there's the shrimp boat. That's a good picture of the shrimp boat. How crazy is that, huh? I mean, we had some big ones coming through. That's the storm, y'all. So anyway, I wanted to share those with you. And I do have a really cool video because we were up front, so we could only, you know, do so much. And so we have video behind us. I mean, people were still coming in the rain and everything. It was awesome. Absolutely awesome. Y'all, they're doing this all over the country. So try to, you know, look up in your area if you have a boat, or even if you can maybe, you know, go around somewhere and wave your flag. You know, something to just show support. The president, I'm getting goosebumps because the president is seeing this. The president can see, and he needs this so much right now. He is getting grief from everybody, and he needs us right now to show support and how much we love him. This is probably keeping him going every single day. We have to do this, and he sees it. He sees what we're doing, y'all. He needs to see more of it. So try to do anything you can to get a boat parade going. We're having a lot of Jeepers for Trump, so they're having Jeep parades. We have to show him we love him, we support him, and to keep going. Could you imagine being in his position right now? Media getting on him. You got Republicans that not even supporting him. The Democrats are ruthless and disgusting. This is what he needs. This is what's keeping him going, y'all, okay? We have to show him. Hashtag Trump 2020, okay? Okay, so every Monday, I post it a Mega Monday. And I usually ask a question. It's on my Hirstified page. And this week, I had my Mega Monday. The virtual Democratic Convention is this week. Are you watching? Let me tell you. I had 178 comments on this, on just the Facebook. And all of them, no, no. H, no. Rather watch paint dry. That's what Jack Carter says. I love it. I'd rather watch paint dry. Let's see. Here's another one. Nope. No way. They are evil. Definitely. We know that. And then Charlie Morris says, no, can't stand cheaters or liars. And a lot of them, who was the one that said she had a, I don't know. It was hilarious. But I did want to show you some of the memes that they were, oh, here we go. This guy says, Robert Hoover says, no. What new lies can they tell? They are all working for that Nazi Soros for sure. This Alan Beisler goes, I'd rather eat dirt. Ah. That's a good one. Terry says, forgive me, I may see the stupidity of it. Oh, I love it. Oh, this one. I love this one. Donna Snow goes, I need to organize my sock drawer. I love it. Oh, Donna Main says, I would rather watch grass grow. Okay, but I want to show you these. These are so, like, on spot. Oh, hit the wrong thing. Give me a second. Hold up. Here we go. All right. We don't need this anymore. We don't need this anymore. So this is the one I want to show. Look at it. This is it, y'all. This is why probably the Democrats are really don't minding that the, you know, they have Biden as a candidate, because he's just a little puppet for them. The man can't think for himself. The man can't even read a teleprompter. I mean, it's really sad. It really is. I really am kind of starting to feel sorry for the dude. You know, this one is so true. Trump's reversing all of my policies, Obama, and then Jesus, Democrats are reversing all of mine. You can't get any more truer than that. The Democrats, they're sick. They really are. You got, during this virus, you know, you can go to Walmart, you can protest, you can do all this stuff, yet you can't go to church. It's not good. And I'm telling you, this wearing mask thing, if you're feeding into it, it's just the beginning. It's absolutely just the beginning. Don't be fearful of this virus. Don't. And there is no race hate, y'all. There really isn't. I walk around and I don't see it. I mean, I don't. I say hi to everybody. I don't care what color you are, gender, no gender, your fluidity or whatever you are. I mean, I don't care. I'm going to say hi to you. I mean, we're America and we're Americans. We all bleed red. And if you're a true patriot, we all bleed red, white, and blue. That's all you need. You don't need anything else tagged on you. You don't need to be African American. You don't be European American. You don't need to be anything else but American. And America's the best country on earth. Why are you complaining? You would not be able to do anything of what you do right now if you were in any other country. You think you would have protests in Russia like that? Yeah, they'd annihilate you. You think you can do all of this stuff in another country? No. So stop feeling oppressed. Stop complaining and live and be proud of being in America. That's it. So I appreciate you hanging in there with me. I hope you got Hirstified on my show. And check me out every Tuesday, 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. I'll be here. If you have anything or like any topics or something you want me to go over or guest, let me know. Also, too, don't forget, we partnered up with New Right Network, and they've got awesome shows. So be sure to check them out, especially if you want to subscribe. You can go to nrnplus.com and go ahead and subscribe. And like I said, you're going to get all the inside scoop. We're also trying to plan some events. Oh, we have town halls now where you can find out about candidates in your area. Again, let me know maybe if there's somebody that you know, have some questions for, and I can get them on the show and talk to them. We need to vet our candidates, people. Even if they're Republican, we have to vet our candidates. We have to get true Republicans in there. And with that, I'm going to go qualify. Tomorrow. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to qualify tomorrow. I'm running again. It's a small office, and it's for the Republican State Central Committee for Louisiana and, for my area. And so that way I can get the scoop on all of the candidates in Louisiana for the entire state. So it'll be kind of cool, because I'm ready to drain the swamp. I'm ready. Come on. We need to stir the pot. And we need more people to stand up and I hate to say, get these career politicians kind of out or straighten them up, one of the two. Okay? So See you next time. Thanks so much. And remember, ladies and gents, to MAGA every day.